Hello, I thank iPaid Bribe and Janagraha for providing me an opportunity to put forth my idea on corruption. My name is N.V. Krishna Kumar, and my idea is based on a column I wrote in Deccan Herald 4 months ago. So it's basically a market-driven solution rather than a government-driven solution. And it is based on the age-old economic premise that businesses and people respond to incentives. So my basic idea is to boycott products and services of two most corrupt companies in each sector. So the examples I had given in my column are real estate sector and entertainment sector, which are the most corrupt in our country. And then I had also mentioned the 2G spectrum, telephone spectrum, this one. So if you take the entertainment industry, 75 to 80% of the movies do not make money. So how do the industry still survive? It's because of black money and illegal money that goes into the system. So what does it do? It'll have a ripple effect on everything. So the customers who are supplying to them will think, oh, okay, this my company might not survive because customers are boycotting their products. People will think before joining. Cricket will become cleaner because nobody wants to play to an empty stadium. Movie theater owners will struggle to find, you know, how to keep their images of being not corrupt and provide some clean entertainment to us. So how does it help corruption at retail level? So once you start boycotting, corrupt money and illegal money will start coming out of the political system. So the basic problem with retail corruption is bad governance by bad people. So in order to improve governance and make governance good, you need a lot of good people in the system to get rid of retail corruption. So once you get rid of black money and illegal money out of the political system, there will be more people who come forward who are good and who wants to do public service rather than profit motive for politics. So basically, if you reduce, say, election expenses to 10 lakhs to 50 lakhs for an MLA or an MP constituency, then you need only 100 people to give you 50,000 rupees to contest an election. Or if you want 10,000 rupees from 100 people to give you to contest an election. So once you reduce black money and illegal money, you will get good people into the system who will improve governance. So the flip side of this is there are a lot of people who suggest that you can use technology, you can use punishment as a deterrent like the Lokpal bill or appeal to the moral consciences. Why I think all these will not work? Moral consciences we have been appealing for the last 40 years and it has never worked. Not just in India and everywhere worldwide it is proven that it doesn't work. Punishment as a deterrent. Many of the foreign countries serve an example. China, for example, has hanged 25 people for corruption and they have put innumerable number of public servants in jail. But now, today, China, they're talking about efficient corruption and inefficient corruption. So they want to legalize efficient corruption and they want to get rid of inefficient corruption. So it does not stop from government servants being corrupt. And technology is the best. Many people naively think that technology can get rid of corruption. Bangalore and Karnataka are the best examples of why technology will not work. So take 3 years ago when former chief minister said that he will put all the details of money collected for flood relief on a website, both income and expenditure. Today you don't know how much money was collected and you don't know how many houses were built for the schemes in North Karnataka. There is no information absolutely on the website and no trace of money what happened. The best example is Bhumi. Bhumi software was hailed as one of the best by World Bank and they said this software will change governance in Karnataka. 10 years later we know land deals, land grabbing is rampant in Karnataka, Bhumi has not stopped anything and land deals are done in a non-transparent way with too much of black money in it. So it is for people who are naively think that technology can solve some of the corruption problems, it is not a workable solution. The best example technology has come up with often is the railway system. But what they don't tell you is the number of trains have increased, which means the supply of seats and berths in railways have increased. So that is what has reduced corruption. For example, when I was a teenager, there were only 3 trains going from Bangalore to Chennai. Today there are 9 trains. Similarly to Bombay, there are only two trains. Today there are four trains from Bangalore and eight passing through Krishnarajapuram. Similarly to Delhi, there was only one train. Today there are four trains going to Delhi. So the supply of seats and this one and increase, all computerization has done is increased efficiency because each terminal has become a booking counter. When I was a teenager, there were only two counters, Bangalore City and Bangalore Cantonment Railway Station. So what technology has done is increase efficiency. How corruption has been reduced is now increasing the supply of seats and berths in railways. So my idea, what basically it does is to tackle wholesale corruption. Wholesale corruption is because of the bureaucratic because of the nexus between bureaucrats, politicians, and businessmen. So once you break that nexus, black money or illegal money will come down in the process, and so the political system will get cleansed. So once the political system gets cleansed, you get good people to serve you as public servants in government, and once good governance comes into the picture, it will solve the retail corruption. So I want people to take a hard look at this idea, think about it, understand it, and hopefully vote for it. So it becomes the best idea, and I'm sure if idea is implemented, the bureaucratic politician businessman nexus can be broken in 3-4 years, and then in a decade our country will become almost, the corruption level will become to the minimum in our country.